I'm Rob Brown, and this is Instrumental. Tattoos. I've been tattooing now for 27 years. I'll be celebrating 20 years in Windsor this November. Very first tattoo machine was a National Deluxe nickel-plated swing gate. You know what? They're a collector's item now. They're vintage. They're like $1,000 a pop, but I think I bought mine for $150. Some are made with sentimental keys. Some are just vintage frames that are hard to come by now. I got all the new fancy toys too, but I got some old machines that are a little bit more special, whether it be who made them or what they're made from. Components like this one here is just strictly built from keys. A frame like that, you'll never find another one like that in the world. This machine here is a knife that belonged to Robert Meikle Brown, my grandfather. He passed away in the early 60s. My dad emigrated to Canada in 1965. He came with a bunch of little trinkets and tchotchkes, and this was bestowed to me. When he built it, I just thought it was gonna be a real fancy kind of paperweight, but I use it every day. And I often wonder what my grandfather would think if he knew what his addiction to cigarettes would turn into. Years ago, you never used to get individually rolled cigarettes. You used to get a log of solid tobacco, and the knife that's been sharpened down to a stump was his way of grinding up his tobacco and rolling up his cigarettes. Yeah. It was Father's Day 2009 when I got that given to me. That's why I often think, like, what would this man think of this insignificant object that I've turned into something that I used to make a living from? Is this going to be like the flux capacitor component in my son's time machine? I don't know.